Well, praise the Lord. Good morning. God bless you. Welcome to Victory in the Valley. This is Pastor Kevin Ortiz, and we're so excited. We thank God for you for watching today's program. This program is going to change your life. We have recorded this message from Faith Pleases God Church here in Harlingen, Texas. And so we are friends. We are brothers in Christ. We're your neighbors. Amen. And God is doing great things at this church. If you ever have a time, please come on out on Sunday morning at 11 a.m. and come visit me. I know that God has a special blessing for you. You need to come and receive the Word of God. You will never be the same again. Amen. In today's message, I know it's going to be a blessing to your life. The anointing of God is upon it. I want you to receive the Word of God so that your heart will be open. But understand this, that God will lift up your faith through the Word of God, and then things will begin to change because you open up your heart for God to move. Amen. I pray that this message blesses your life and that things will change in your life in Jesus' name. Father, I ask that you touch them. I ask that you use this message to have big impact in their life. Bless them in the name of Jesus. Lord, I ask you to heal them, protect them, and provide for them, Father God. Thank you, Lord, for stirring up their faith to receive your word today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Don't change that channel, because my father would always say, and I say it as well, it gets gooder and gooder. Thank you for watching today's program of Victory in the Valley.
Let's read Mark 11.
Vamos a Marcos, capítulo 11.
Mark chapter 11. How many of you here needs miracle from God?
¿Cuántos de ustedes necesitan un milagro de Dios aquí en esta noche?
Are you sure? Yeah.
¿Seguros?
Are you sure?
¿Estás seguro?
You need a miracle?
Yeah. ¿Necesito un milagro?
You need a miracle?
Yeah. ¿Necesito un milagro?
We will see miracles tonight. Yeah.
Vamos a recibir milagros en esta noche.
Hallelujah. Let's believe God together.
Vamos a creer a Dios juntos. Él es un buen Dios.
When Pastor Ray said something, it struck my spirit. He said, we have the victory.
Cuando Pastor Ray dijo que cuando tenemos victoria, me tocó
mi espíritu.
Tenemos la victoria.
We have victory.
Tenemos la victoria.
Hallelujah. Mark 11, chapter 22 and 23.
Marcos 11, 22 y 23.
And Jesus answering with them, said unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said.
Amen.
He shall have whatsoever he said.
Va a tener lo que él ha dicho.
Can I come downstairs?
Yes. Come on down.
I like to look at your faces. Hallelujah. Jesus said, have faith in God.
Jesús dijo, tenga fe en Dios.
Amen. Some translations render it a little bit different.
Algunas traducciones lo tienen un poquito diferente.
Some translations says have God kind of faith.
Algunas traducciones dicen tenga la fe de Dios. El tipo de fe de Dios.
Have God kind of faith.
Tenga el tipo de fe de Dios.
Hallelujah. And then verse 23 tells us how this God kind of faith is manifested.
El versículo 23 ahí es cuando ese tipo de fe en Dios se manifiesta.
It says, verily I say unto you, whosoever shall say to this mountain.
Dice, porque de cierto les digo que cualquiera que diga este monte,
be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that whatsoever he said cometh shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said.
Amen.
Let me tell you, most Christians think they know this verse of scripture.
Casi todos los cristianos piensan que sabe esta escritura.
But they don't know it.
pero no lo saben.
There's so much revelation here.
Hay tanta revelación aquí.
In fact, you see, God's word, the word of God is so deep.
La palabra de Dios es tan profunda.
That it will take the Holy Ghost to unveil to you.
Que si el Espíritu Santo nos revela.
There is so much greatness, power, mysteries in the word that God speaks.
Hay tantos misterios dentro de la palabra que él habla.
I thought I had an understanding of the scripture.
Yo pensé que yo entendía esa escritura.
Some years ago.
Ciertos años para atrás.
But something happened.
Pero algo pasó.
Tell your neighbor something happened.
Dígale a su vecino, algo pasó.
Follow me, please.
Sígame.
I came into South Africa from Nigeria.
Vine a Sudáfrica desde Nigeria.
And then started doing street evangelism.
Y fue las calles evangelizando.
In South Africa.
En el Sudáfrica.
And there's a place, there's a town, which is the oldest town in South Africa.
Es un pueblo el más viejito en Sudáfrica.
Full of diseases, full
mucha
of crime,
mucho
full of
crimen,
poverty.
Mucha pobreza.
And then the Lord sent me there.
Y el Señor me envió ahí.
To go from house to house.
Para ir de casa en casa.
Pray for the sick.
Y orar por los enfermos.
People are dying of HIV.
Personas están muriendo del SIDA.
And I was doing that. This was 2005.
Eso fue en 2005.
This was 2005. And then I was doing that. One day, I was tired, and then I went back home.
Un día estaba cansado y regresé a mi casa.
Then when I got home,
cuando llegué a mi casa,
I slept in my room. I didn't expect anything.
Yo fui y dormí. No esperaba nada.
You know, when you're tired, when you've done street evangelism, you know what I'm talking about?
Cuando usted está en las calles, usted está cansado.
I got home. All I wanted was to eat and just...
Lo único que quería era comer y ir a dormir.
Sleep. So I got home and I just... I didn't know when I just dozed off.
Nada más me dormí.
And then suddenly something happened.
Y de momento algo pasó.
I don't think was up to an hour.
Quizás una hora después.
The roof of the room.
La parte arriba de la casa.
The roof of my room just opened.
El techo de mi cuarto se abrió.
And then I saw an angel.
Y vi a un ángel.
Came down to me.
Y vino abajo hacia mí.
And he said to me,
y me dijo a mí,
that I should tell my colleague.
Que le debo decir a mis compañeros.
I was staying with a family.
Yo estaba quedándome con una familia.
I was staying with a family that they were pastors.
Una familia que eran pastores.
He was married. I wasn't married then.
Él estaba casado, pero yo no estaba casado en ese momento.
And then he had some problem.
Tenía algunos problemas.
In his office.
En su oficina.
He was into IT, information technology.
Estaba en las cosas de tecnología.
Now, he didn't tell me anything.
No me dijo nada.
But God knew all this.
Pero Dios sabe todo.
This man was about to lose his job.
Este hombre estaba a punto de perder su trabajo.
In fact, let me say he has lost his job.
Quizá ya lo había perdido.
He was employed as a consultant.
Era como un consultor.
And then he messed up the job given to him.
Y como que dañó todo lo que el trabajo que tenía.
I want to connect the two together. When the angel came down.
Cuando el ángel vino.
The angel just stretched his hand like this.
Y el ángel puso su mano así como
la. And then it was like a screen.
Y luego había como un velo,
like a TV screen,
como una screen de TV,
of my colleague's life.
Podía ver como una película de la vida de este pastor, que yo la podía ver frente a mí.
I was on the bed, but I was looking at the supernatural screen.
Yo estaba en mi cama, pero era como un screen super sobrenatural.
And I saw him.
Y lo vi
complaining to his wife.
diciéndole a su esposa.
That I made a mistake.
Diciéndole que ya cometí un error a su esposa.
Concerning the job given to me.
Del trabajo que le habían dado.
And because of this mistake.
Y por este error.
When my contract expires.
Cuando ya mi contrato ya expire.
They are not going to give me another job.
No me van a dar otro trabajo.
Because in IT.
Porque en eso de tecnología.
You know, you are employed based on your expertise.
Uno le da un trabajo en base a su experiencia.
And he said, there's a big job to be given to him, but because he messed up this particular job he's handling, they are not going to give him that job.
Y él iba a tener quizás un trabajo mucho más grande, pero porque cometió un error en este pequeño, quizás no le den el trabajo grande.
I saw it within seconds when the angel did like this.
Y lo vi como en segundos cuando el ángel puso la mano así.
And then the angel told me.
Y luego el ángel me dijo.
Even though.
Aunque.
They've told him they're not going to give him the big job.
Le dijeron que no le van a dar ese trabajo grande.
Because he made a mistake with the present assignment.
Porque hizo un error con el que tenía el trabajo que tenía ahora. Dígale.
The angel. Oh, if you see an angel, you don't know. They don't speak like a weakling.
Si ve un ángel, ellos no hablan así calladito.
Hallelujah. God is a God of power.
Dios es un Dios de poder.
The angel said, "Tell him."
El ángel dijo, "Dile."
That if he will obey Mark 11:23.
Y si él obedece a Marcos 11:23.
It will work for him.
Va a trabajar para él.
Even though they told him they're not going to give him that job.
Aunque le dijeron que no le iban a dar ese trabajo.
Tell him.
Dile.
That Mark 11:23 will work for him.
Que Marcos 11:23 va a trabajar para él.
That is the way the angel told me.
Así fue que me lo dijo el
ángel a mí. That was the exact word. He said, "Tell him."
Sus palabras exactas.
Mark 11:23.
Dile, Marcos 11:23.
We work for him.
Le va a trabajar
tell
para
him.
Él. Dile.
Mark 11:23.
Marcos 11:23.
We work for
va
him.
A trabajar para él.
Tell him.
Dile.
Mark 11:23.
Marcos 11:23.
We work for
va
him.
Va a trabajar para él.
Hallelujah. And then as soon as the angel told me, the screen disappeared and the angel disappeared.
Enseguida que el ángel terminó de decirme eso, todo se desapareció, el screen y él mismo.
And then I woke up.
Y luego yo me levanté.
And I began.
Y empecé.
To worship God.
Alabar a Dios.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
For this secret.
Por este secreto.
The man did not tell me anything that happened to him.
El ángel no le dijo nada de lo que le pasó a él. Oh, no, el hombre, perdón, el hombre.
Two
el
days later, I called him and I told him.
Dos días después llamé al pastor y le dije.
I said, "This is what the Lord told me."
Esto fue lo que el Señor me dijo.
He broke down.
Y ahí él empezó ahí a
he couldn't
adorar.
Believe it.
No lo pudo creer.
He said, "Now I know."
Ahora yo sé.
You are a prophet.
Que usted es un profeta.
He said, "Now I know."
Ahora yo sé.
He said, "Because I had not told anybody except my wife."
No le he dicho a nadie excepto a mi esposa.
Because I was owing a lot of bills.
Porque yo tenía muchas deudas.
And they had told me.
Y me han dicho.
They will not give me another assignment.
Que ya no me van a dar otro trabajo.
Because I made a mistake with the present assignment.
Hice un error con el que tenía ahora enfrente.
That I did not do it very well.
Que no lo hice muy bien.
So the agency that recruited me.
La agencia que le contrató.
Said they are not going to give me another job. I can't be relied on.
No le van a dar otro contrato.
And he was shocked. I said, God said I should tell you.
Dios dije que yo le debo decir.
Mark 11:23 will work.
Marcos 11:23 va a trabajar para usted.
And so I taught him Mark 11:23.
So le enseñé Marcos 11:23.
Let me tell you, this man was a pastor.
Y déjeme decirle, ese señor era un pastor.
That's why I said sometimes you think you know a verse of scripture, you don't know.
Y por eso le digo.
Until you are confronted with a mountain.
A veces uno no sabe las escrituras como uno piensa hasta que esté confrontado con una montaña.
Aleluya. I taught him, I said, "Pastor, you know about Mark 11:23. He said, "I know it." He said, "But let me, God, the angel said I should teach you."
El Señor me dijo que le enseñe sobre Marcos 11:23.
So I taught him.
So le enseñé.
And then after I taught him.
Y luego que le enseñé.
And then I said, let's pray.
Okay, vamos a orar cuando termine.
And then I told him, I said, give me the name.
Dame el nombre.
Of the agency.
De la agencia.
That employed you.
Que te dio trabajo.
And the agency that is supposed to give you that big job.
Y de la agencia que te supone que te dé ese contrato grande.
So he wrote it down. So I looked at the name. I said, okay.
Mira el nombre. Okay.
According to Mark 11:23.
De acuerdo a Marcos 11:23.
I began to speak to that agency.
Empecé a hablarle a esa agencia.
The Bible says, whosoever shall say.
La palabra dice que
to this mountain.
Le dijera esta montaña.
To this mountain.
Esta montaña.
I said, this agency is the mountain.
Esta agencia es una montaña.
So I began to speak to them.
Eso empecé a hablarle a la agencia.
I spoke to that agency.
Y le hablé a esa agencia.
And I told the agency.
Y le dije a la agencia.
I said, in the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
I command you.
Yo te comando.
To employ my friend.
Yo declaro que
in the name
vas
of
a darle
Jesus.
Trabajo a mi amigo en el
I command
de Jesús.
You.
En el nombre de Jesús.
To employ my friend.
Declaro
in the
que
name
vas
of Jesus.
A mi amigo.
I command you.
En el nombre de Jesús.
To employ my friend.
Declaro que
in
le
the
vas
name of Jesus.
A mi amigo.
And I told the pastor. I said,
pastor,
I said, now you are going to. I've helped you. You are going to exercise your faith.
Ahora yo estoy leyendo, pero tú tienes que ejercer tu fe.
I said, now speak.
Ahora tú habla.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Tell the company to employ you.
Ahora ve y dile a la compañía que te
contrate. Tell the company to employ you.
Ve y dile a la compañía que te dé trabajo.
According to Mark 11:23.
Y de acuerdo a Marcos 11:23.
And he began to do so.
Y empezó a hablarle así.
You know, Pastor, initially he was speaking with a weak voice.
Al principio estaba hablando, declarando ahí un poquito bajo.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. En nombre de Jesús.
In Jesus' name.
Bien, bien, débil. En nombre de Jesús.
I said, no, this will not work.
Bien, no, eso no va a trabajar.
Faith has a strong voice.
Fe tiene una voz.
Faith does not speak with a weak voice.
Y fe no habla con una voz débil.
Faith does not speak with a weak voice.
Fe no habla con una voz débil.
The voice of faith is powerful.
La voz de la fe es poderosa.
The voice of faith is powerful.
La voz de la fe es poderosa.
And the Bible says.
Y la Biblia dice.
And Jesus spoke with a loud voice.
Habló con una voz alta.
Hallelujah. At the tomb of Lazarus.
En la tumba de Lázaro.
He spoke with a loud voice.
Y habló con una voz fuerte.
No, not with a weak voice.
No con una voz débil.
You know, Jesus didn't say, Lazarus.
Jesús no dijo, ay, Lázaro.
Come forth.
Ven, sal.
Lazarus. Come forth.
Ven, sal.
No.
No.
The Bible says.
La Biblia dice.
And Jesus said.
Y Jesús
Lazarus.
Dijo, Lázaro.
Come forth.
Sal.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith has a voice.
Fe tiene una voz.
If it is faith.
Si es fe.
The voice is powerful.
La voz es poderosa.
So I commanded him.
So le dije que declarara.
And I said now.
Ahora.
Say to that to that company to employ
ahora,
you.
Declara a la
tell them in Jesus' name.
Declare en nombre
employ
de Jesús
me.
Que te dé trabajo.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Employ me.
En el nombre
in Jesus'
de Jesús,
name.
Dame trabajo.
Employ me.
Y siguió declarando.
Amen. And then I said, Pastor, it's done. Let's thank God. Let's worship him.
Okay, ya terminamos, Pastor. Ya está
God.
Hecho. Vamos a alabar a Dios.
We thank God.
Vamos a darle gracias a Dios.
And then for three weeks I didn't see him.
Y por tres semanas no lo vi.
Then the third week he called me.
Y luego de las terceras semanas me llamó.
He said, Pastor.
Pastor.
Something has happened.
Algo pasó.
You need to come and see me. You need to come and see me.
Tiene que venir a verme, por favor.
He said, a miracle has happened.
Un milagro ha pasado.
Then I went to see him.
Y fui a verlo.
Exactly what the angel showed me.
Exactamente lo que el ángel me enseñó.
So the angel showed me that if he will obey Mark 11:23, it will work for him.
That
big job will be given to him.
Que ese trabajo grande, contrato grande, le iba a ser dado a él.
He said, "You will not believe it."
Me dijo, "No me vas a creer."
It's not done.
No está terminado.
If an agency,
si una agencia,
that employs information technologies.
Una agencia que contrata.
I don't know whether they do that in South Africa. There are some people in, who employ right. special. They give you contracts.
Yes.
Right. So it says, if they blacklist you, nobody can employ you.
Y si esa agencia lo pone en esa lista negra, nadie te va a dar trabajo.
It was blacklisted.
Él habían puesto en la lista negra.
Meaning, his life is finished. He won't be able to get a job.
Su vida está terminada, no va a poder trabajar.
And then he had 3 houses to pay for.
Y tenía tres.
And he had 2 cars to pay for.
Tres casas, dos
he was
carros.
Crying. He said, where will I find money to pay all these bills?
¿Cómo voy a poder? Empezó a llorar. ¿Cómo voy a poder pagar todos esos biles?
He said, Pastor, I need a miracle.
Pastor, necesito un milagro.
He didn't tell me. He said he was crying.
Él estaba llorando.
He was talking to his wife that if God doesn't do anything, we are finished.
Estaba diciendo se puede que si Dios no hace algo estamos terminados.
But he didn't know that God has appeared to me.
Pero no se ve que Dios me haya aparecido
to
a mí.
Tell him one verse of scripture.
Para decirle a él un we verso de escritura para su milagro.
One verse of scripture.
Un versículo de
we
la
give
palabra
him a miracle.
Para su milagro.
The company that blacklisted him.
Esa compañía que lo puso en la lista negra.
Called him.
Le llamó.
And said.
Y le dijo.
We understand you've made a mess with the last assignment we gave you.
Tengo entendido que usted cometió errores con el último trabajo que le dimos.
However,
pero
there is this big assignment we wanted to give you before.
Pero hay un trabajo que queríamos darte antes.
Which we canceled.
Ese que lo cancelamos.
Because you made a mess.
Porque usted hizo un mal trabajo aquí.
Of the last assignment.
En el del último trabajo.
But we have decided.
Pero hemos decidido
to give you that big assignment.
Pero ya decimos darte ese contrato grande.
It doesn't matter.
No importa.
Whatever you have done.
No importa lo que usted ha hecho.
It doesn't matter the mistake you have done.
No importa el error que ha cometido.
We will give you another chance.
Le vamos a dar otra oportunidad.
Hallelujah.
Come and sign.
Ven y firma.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When he told me, I rejoiced.
Cuando él me dijo, estaba muy contento.
When he told me, I rejoiced. That was a miracle.
Eso fue un milagro.
That was an impossible situation.
Eso era una situación muy imposible.
Because they had told him,
porque le habían dicho,
you are blacklisted.
Ya usted está en la lista
you can't
negra.
Get any job again.
Nunca jamás va a poder trabajar.
But God reversed the decision.
Pero Dios reversó
God
esa
reversed
decisión.
The decision.
Dios reversó esa decisión.
If he will obey one verse of scripture.
Si él hubiera obedecido un verso de escritura.
I'm telling you, one verse of scripture will get you a miracle.
Le digo, un versículo de la Biblia va a cambiar su vida.
It takes only one verse of scripture to get you a miracle.
Nada más toma un solo versículo de escritura para darle un milagro.
And that verse of scripture is Mark 11:23.
Y ese versículo es Marcos
11:23. The angel told me.
El ángel me dijo.
To tell him.
Decirle a él.
It will work for him.
Que va a trabajar para él.
I want you to turn to somebody and tell him or her.
Quiero decirle a alguien.
Mark 11:23 will work for you.
Marcos 11:23 va a trabajar para usted.
Tell somebody.
Dígale a alguien.
Tell somebody.
Dígale a alguien que
come on, turn to
Marcos
somebody.
11:23
turn
va
to two people
a trabajar para usted.
And tell them Mark 11:23 will work for you. It will work for you. Oh, come on. It will work for you, brother.
Diciendo,
it will work for you, sister.
Para usted.
How many of you
diciendo,
need a miracle?
Cuando se
do you need a miracle? Mark 11:23 will work for you.
Marcos 11:23
I said, Mark 11:23 will work for you. Mark 11:23 will work for you. Mark 11:23 will work for you. If you will believe it, my dear, it will work for you.
Si lo cree, va a trabajar
Jesus
para usted.
Says, if you will speak to the mountain,
dijo Jesús, si usted va a hablar,
what is a mountain?
A la montaña.
Something that seemingly looks bigger than you.
¿Qué es una montaña? Algo que se ve mucho más grande que usted.
What is a mountain?
¿Qué es una montaña?
A mountain is a problem.
Una montaña es un problema.
That is beyond your natural ability to solve.
Que es mucho más allá de lo que usted puede hacer naturalmente.
What is a mountain?
¿Qué es una montaña?
A mountain is a difficulty.
Una montaña es algo muy difícil.
A mountain can be a disease.
Una montaña puede ser
a mountain
una enfermedad.
Can be a financial problem.
Puede ser un problema financiero.
A mountain can be a marital problem.
Puede ser un problema en su matrimonio.
A mountain can be a child.
Una montaña puede ser un niño.
A mountain can be a husband.
Puede ser un esposo.
Some women, some wives are a mountain.
Algunas veces las esposas son montañas.
Hallelujah. Some husbands are a mountain.
A veces los esposos son montañas.
Hallelujah. There are some people, there are some ladies whose husbands are not coming to church at all.
Hay muchas señoras que los esposos no vienen a
that
la iglesia.
Man is a mountain to that woman.
Ese hombre es una montaña para esa mujer.
Because he's always going to drink.
Porque va a beber.
Some men go after other women.
Y van detrás de otras
that's
mujeres.
A mountain in that marriage.
Eso es una montaña en
so
ese
anything
matrimonio.
Can become a mountain. Can be a mountain.
Puede ser una montaña.
But God says,
pero Dios
you
dice,
shall speak to the mountain.
Usted va a hablar Mahala la montaña.
Bro, give somebody high five. Give somebody high five.
Dígale,
give somebody high five. Hallelujah. Give somebody high five. Hallelujah. You can speak to the mountain.
Usted puede hablarle a su montaña.
God spoke to us and told us that we are supposed to raise up 1,000 disciples. The word of God says that we are supposed to go out to and make disciples of all nations. Have you been discipled? Have you been taught the ways of the Lord? Have you been led by the Holy Ghost as you have been instructed by someone who's been taught how to live for God? We have people that want to walk with you. We have people that are great men and women of God that want to pray over your life, and that they want to take on the responsibility of seeing you grow in Jesus Christ. Today is the day to sign up. Today is the day to become part of this discipleship program. Become part of this army that we're raising up to serve the Lord. This is a daily discipleship program that you will walk with our spiritual trainers and you will experience the goodness of God. Come by Faith Pleases God Church, and we will match you up with somebody who will encourage you, who will walk with you, who will pray over your life, and believe God for the goodness of God for you and your family. You need to become a disciple. Come by Faith Pleases God Church, or call 956-412-5600 and say, I want to become a disciple of Jesus Christ. Thank you guys for watching today's program, and thank you for signing up to become a disciple today. It's a free ministry just for you. God bless you, and we'll see you in a short while here at church worshiping the Lord with us. God bless you. We love you. God bless. My friends, I thank you guys for watching Victory in the Valley. I want to encourage you to keep on building your faith. We have a program called, it's actually a radio station online, FPG Radio, and you're going to be able to hear the word of God being preached 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. The more you hear the word of God, the stronger your faith is and the greater things you will do for the glory of God. So hear the word of God through FPG Radio. That's FPG Radio. You can find it at fpgradio.com. You can download it on your phone, on your app on the Android and iPhone. And just listen to the word of God. We have different men and women of God that are anointed by the Holy Spirit preaching the gospel 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Some of them have already gone on to glory, but they left a great testimony. Amen. God bless you guys. Go to fpgradio.com and don't forget to visit us this Sunday morning at Faith Pleases God Church. God bless you. We'll see you next time. God bless.